tonight. Give him thanks. Give him praise. Worship him for who he is and who he's been to you. For all the wonderful things he's done. Even though you're yet to see them, just know it's coming your way. Because that's who he is. That's the truth of who he is. We worship you, Jesus. Blessed be your holy name. Lift our hands in worship. Saturate this place, God. And we sing, Holy Spirit, you are welcome here. Come flood this place and fill the atmosphere. Your glory, God, is what our hearts long for. To be overcome by your presence, Lord. Your presence, Lord. Your presence, Lord. Your presence, Lord. Come on, say, Holy Spirit.
Holy Spirit, you are welcome.
Come flood this place.
Come flood this place and fill the earth.
Your glory, God.
Your glory, God, is what our hearts long for.
To be overcome.
To be overcome by your presence.
Sing, Holy Spirit.
Your presence, Lord.
your presence, Yahweh, Yahweh, Yahweh. Yeshua, Mashiach, the King of Kings.
Your presence, Lord.
Oh, and let us become more aware of your presence. Let us experience the glory of your goodness. Let us become more aware of your presence. Let us experience the glory of your goodness. Let us become.
Let us become more aware of your presence.
If you know that's what you want, come on, lift your voice and say, God, all we want is you. All we need is you. We want your presence. Fill us. Come on, Lord. Jesus, your presence is here right now and it's moving amidst us, and we know that you are working a new thing in us, and we lift our voice and say, Lord, we receive your presence. Lord, we receive you. Lord, you are here and you are in our lives. Lord, we know you are manifesting right now. Come on, speak to him. My soul says yes. Says yes, it says yes. My soul says yes to your will. My soul says yes, says yes.
It 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 says yes.
naja mbele zako Mungu wangu nikiwa nazo heshima zote ninakiri yale uyatendayo Jambele zako
Jambele zako Mungu wangu
Nikiwa nazo heshi wonderful works. If you know you believe and you have confessed him to be your personal Lord and Savior, if you know that by his grace is why we are here today, it is by his power and not our own, it is by his kindness, it is by his mercy, it is by his favor. Many did not wake up today, but we have been crucified with Christ and we have shed his blood upon us, and he has set us aside and he has delivered us from the hands of the enemy. He has protected us. He's our provider. He's our healer. He's the one who is above every other thing, the name above every other name, the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, El Shaddai, Elohim, Adonai. Come on, lift your voice to him and give him praise. Give him thanks. Adore him. Magnify his name. He alone is worthy. He alone is worthy. He alone is worthy to be glorified. We bless you, Jesus. Sing wewe ni mwema.
Wewe ni mwema.
How far na nishwi.
How far na nishwi. Wewe ni mwema.
Come on, lift your voice. Sing wewe ni mwema. and we love you forever. We love you forever. Oh Lord, we love you forever. God, we profess with our hearts.
We love you forever.
We sing.
We love you
forever. Sing, we love you,
we love
forever.
Forever.
We love you,
we love
forever.
Forever.
We love you,
we love you forever.
And indeed, God, we love you this morning, and thank you for your love to us. As the Bible says in the book of 1 John 4, that we love him because he first loved us. I want someone just to go before God this morning, thanking him, telling him that we love you this morning. Father God, we love you, Father, for your mercies, for your goodness, for what, Lord, you've done to our lives, Jehovah God. This morning we say we love you. We thank you for your mercies. We thank you for your everlasting King, my God and my Savior, that this day, God, we are here, Lord, to testify of your great and mighty things, to testify, Lord, of what you've done, Lord, in our institution, to thank you, God, for the great things that, Lord, you have for us, Jehovah, and thank you for this day, Lord, as we receive it, just like David declared, that this is the day that, God, you have made, that we will rejoice and be glad in it, Abba Father. We thank you for this morning. We thank you for our personal life. Just go before God. Thank him for how for your life. Thank him for what he has been in your life, for who he is in your life. And God, we come to testify this morning, thinking of your love even upon our lives. That mighty God, you have taken us, God. You have pulled us, God, from the different pit, mighty God. And today, Lord, we are here, Lord, only because of your love. And we celebrate your love, mighty God. We celebrate your love this morning, and thank you for such a love for us. Thank you, God, for you are such loving God. We thank you, Father. Thank you for Desta. I want someone just to thank God for Desta, for the great and mighty thing that God has done to us, even through our Vice Chancellor. I want us just to say thank you. And Father God, we are grateful. This morning we say thank you for your goodness and faithfulness, mighty God, even upon Desta, mighty Father. We thank you for our student. We thank you for every God worker. We thank you for the management. And we thank you for our Vice Chancellor. And this morning we are before you, God, just to say thank you for your goodness, for your mercies, for God, your love even upon our institution. And we truly thank you. Thank you, God. Psalms 136, the Bible says, verse 1, oh, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, his mercies endures forever. Oh, give thanks to the God of gods, for his mercies endures forever. Oh, give thanks to the Lord of lords, for his mercies endures forever. Verse 4, to him who alone does great wonders, for his mercies endures forever. To him who by wisdom made the heavens, for his love endures forever. And God, thinking of you and thinking of your love towards us, God, we say thank you this morning. We thank you, God, for everything that, Lord, you've done in our personal life, in our institution, God. We say thank you for the great height that, Lord, you are helping us, God, even to move. And thank you for what you have for this, the mighty God. For you have said, my Father, that it's you give us, God, more even than what we ask of, mighty Father. And thank you for your presence, Lord, even in this chapel, as we start this day, as we call upon your name this day, God, as we offer this corporate prayer before you, God. We ask that your presence be with us. We thank God that you walk with us. We thank God that you speak through us, in the name of Jesus. We thank you this morning. We glorify thy name. In Jesus' mighty name we pray and believe. Amen. 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 Thank you, God.
you so much. You may have your seats. Thank you, worship team. May the Lord bless you. Thank you to our band, our production crew, and the ushers for welcoming us so well. I bring you today's announcements. Morning devotion still continues every Monday to Friday from 5 to 6 a.m. at the amphitheater and 3 to 5 a.m. on Tuesday, Thursday, and Sunday at the Rocks. We invite you to start your day the right way with prayer. Midweek fellowship takes place every Wednesday at the ICT Theater from 8 p.m. to 9 p.m. And this is always a great time in the middle of the week to gather, regroup, and fellowship together. For those who have been attending, you are a great encouragement. And we extend a warm welcome to you, and may you bring your friends along as well. This Thursday, we will gather right here in the amphitheater for a special Thursday chapel, and you are invited. Bible study and discipleship sessions will resume next week, and concerning discipleship, you have an opportunity to continue signing up. Yes. Have you been wondering or asking yourself what your purpose is in life? Then wonder no more, because I come bearing good news for you. You are invited to the coolest party powered by the coolest people. Now, what else could we be talking about if not purpose party? For the very first time in 2022, we invite you to join us and let's discover our design together. Purpose Party will be happening this coming Saturday, the 18th of June, at the Nairobi Arboretum from 9 a.m. to 4 p.m. We have lots of great activities lined up for you, so purpose to attend. Transport will be provided. And lastly, if you have an official announcement that you'd like to be made during chapel services, ensure you email it together with all necessary and supporting documents to dcfarthia@daystar.ac.ke latest by Friday, 5 p.m.
Thank you, Tabs. Good morning, everyone. I'll not tell you to pinch your neighbor, but you can welcome them to the house of the Lord. In case you are seated with someone you don't know, please find out who they are. The guy was doing the keyboard. Akwapi, ila likuwa natuchezea keyboard. Come. Thank you. And today, Elsie is here. Elsie did the drums, then disappeared. I think today she is now in the house. Please come, Elsie. Let's appreciate Elsie. I have a presentation, so I'm trying to assemble the band. My backup, Labi and team. The worship team, Yote. That's my... can we have the song, DJ? So we are doing Bwana Usemu Yangu. Now, it is the Vice Chancellor who wanted the worship team to be here. So it's just being creative on how to bring them back. So, Bwana Sehemu yangu, rafiki. Let us sing all of us.
Katika safari yangu, tatembe na wewe. Pamoja.
Stop there for now. You remain here. Let us welcome our Vice Chancellor.
Worship team, can we all be upstanding, please, as we start the worship this morning? First of all, thank you, Chaplain, for inviting me, members of the Daystar community. Hamjambo. Na wageni kutoka America, hamjambo. Muko salama, mulilala vizuri, karibu sana. Karibu sana. I want us to sing It Is So Sweet to Trust Jesus before I share what God has asked me to share with you. But before we start singing, I just want you to reflect at a personal level what God has done for you. 1 minute of reflection. And what a privilege it is to know that in spite of the troubles of the flesh, in spite of all the sins we have committed, in spite of what we could be harboring in our hearts, He has commanded us to ask for forgiveness. He has commanded us to continually worship and pray to Him. And me, I will not tire in knowing that God has just done numerous things in my life and continues to do so as I serve as His vessel in Daystar. So let us go with the video. It is so sweet to trust in Jesus, and my worship team ni mefungua masikio yangu na nitakuwa nikitafuta undani katika sauti zenu. Are we there? Not coming? to trust in Jesus.
Just to take him at his word. Just to rest upon his promise. Just to know that saves the Lord. Jesus, Jesus, how I trust.
You to be seated, and a lot of these hymns we sing were inspired by God. If you look at the history of hymns, most of these people were under extreme tribulations in life, and therefore, they had nowhere else to look but to worship God in prayer. The author of this song was a lady who had gone for a picnic with her husband, and they had one child, a girl. And while they were, that was in New York, and while they were there, just settling down for the picnic, they had a call, a young child's call, or a young boy's call. Help, 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 I'm drowning. And the man instinctively took off and ran towards the direction. And as he jumped into the water to save the boy, he also drowned. So the wife remained with the daughter. What a situation for them to see their father disappear forever. And they were down to the last coin, and she didn't know what they were going to eat. She didn't know what they were going to do. So as she went to open the door to see what can I do next, she found somebody had delivered not just foodstuffs, but a substantial amount of resources. And so she said she would dedicate her life to God. And she took off from the US and came to South Africa as a missionary. And that's how she sang. She wrote those words that day. So when we sing it, sometimes history gives it context and perspective. Learning to trust him. That really it's not about me. Where my next meal will come from, where my provisions will come from. She said, just trust in Jesus. And that's why the opening stanza says, it is so sweet to trust in Jesus, just to take him at his word, and just to rest upon his promise, and just to know, thus save the Lord. By the way, it's a struggle, and many of us, Perhaps, might never internalize what it means when you totally trust in God. And nowadays, I understand when people say the Bible is alive. It represents the Word of God. And so, this morning, God has asked me to talk about the nature and value of wisdom. the nature and value of wisdom. And we all know the word wisdom. I hear sermons, I hear politicians asking God to give them the wisdom of Solomon. What we call Solomonic wisdom. In fact, for us believers, wisdom is equivalent to Solomon. And but people don't understand that there is the Solomon's paradox. He had very wise reflections on matters related to other people's problems. But the paradox was that he never exercised wisdom to himself as an individual. That's the paradox of Solomon. So next time you hear of Solomon's wisdom, God, give me the wisdom, just remember that Solomon's wisdom is a paradox in disposition. I don't want to define what wisdom is, but the quality of having experience, knowledge, and good judgment. Some people will say it's the quality of being wise. The quality of having experience, knowledge, and good judgment. So I hope if you're a good student, either mentally or physically, you should have underlined experience, knowledge, and good judgment. Wisdom is the ability to use your knowledge and experience to make good decisions and judgments. So people say, wow, that was a wise decision. Some of us like to define wisdom as the ability to discern inner qualities and relationships. Wanafunzi wangu wa Kiswahili, wisdom kwa Kiswahili ni hekima. Hekima ama busara. And so as I tackle this message that God has given me, I will sit only in one book and in one chapter. Proverbs 8. And if you could project Proverbs 8, verse 1 to 11, NIV. And I want you to listen to my words keenly. Because my cry to you, as your vice chancellor, is that may we all carry the virtue of wisdom. So, does not wisdom call out? This thing called wisdom is calling out, according to this verse. Does not understanding raise her voice? So when you begin to understand a situation, then wisdom begins to pronounce itself in you. At the highest point along the way, where the paths meet, she takes her stand. She, wisdom, takes her stand. Besides the gate leading into Nairobi or into the city, biblical city that time, at the entrance, she cries aloud. To you, O people, I call out. I raise my voice to all mankind. This is wisdom. You who are simple gain providence. Please, when you have time, look up the word providence. You who are foolish, set your hearts on it. Listen, for I have trustworthy things to say. I open my lips to speak what is right. This is wisdom. My mouth speaks what is true. My lips detest wickedness. Dayster community, I want those words to sink. I open my lips to speak what is right. My mouth speaks what is true. And my lips detest wickedness. So, mimi nataka ujiangalie kwa roho yako. Ujiulize, je, hii hali ya hekima ambayo Mwenyezi Mungu anatarajia kutoka kwangu ipo ama isipo? All the words of my mouth are just. None of them is crooked or perverse. To the discerning, all of them are right. They are upright to those who have found knowledge. So choose my instruction instead of silver, knowledge rather than choice of God, of gold. For wisdom is more precious than rubies, and nothing you desire can compare with her. Dayster University, our journey on this earth is about acquiring wisdom. In fact, some people equate the word wisdom to sagacity. Sagacity, S-A-G-A-C-I-T-Y. Or sapience. A sage is a very wise person. A sage is an embodiment of wisdom. So I'm asking us, as we go into this message, just confront the reading of Proverbs 8:1-11. And I have kept on saying, if we all purposed and struggled to sit in the space of wisdom, you'll be surprised what God will do in your life. And here, wisdom has become a person, and Christ cries out to us, the Creator. Remember, just seeing the beginning tells you that wisdom came earlier. The wisdom of God. So, God approves of those who listen to wisdom's counsel. And those who hate wisdom love death. Think about it. And it's tragic in this country. What matatus are doing on our roads, the agony they're causing on our roads. The agony they are causing families, communities. And my friends, there's no worse death, I keep on saying, than an accident. There's no worse death. Because you are with somebody now, and after an hour, you are told there are no more. And I am not going to get tired of this, because I think what happens on our roads, what happens in our society, just indicates that we hate wisdom. And at Daystar, we shall fight day and night to ensure that we don't go against wisdom. Because we are being told that those who hate wisdom love death. Let me give you an example. If you have a relative or somebody, a sibling, whatever it is, who doesn't do what you want them to do all the time, and takes up to drinking, for example, it will not be long before they disappear from the surface of the earth. Yes. Because obviously people keep telling you, don't do this, don't do that, don't do this, don't do that, but you continue doing it, then if you hate wisdom, you love death. So what am I saying? Wisdom should affect every aspect of our life from beginning to end. And I want you people, including myself, to open all corners of our lives to God's direction and guidance, because that is what is the embodiment of wisdom. And you have seen in this passage of the scripture, wisdom calls from the high hill so that we may hear. I am very clear. We as a Daystar community, we come to worship for chapel. Not because it is a rule, but the wisdom of the founders of this university was that we must accumulate godly wisdom so that we may live. Wisdom calls beside the path that we all travel. So those of you who are in the hostels or outside the hostel, you've got to be wise. And from the gates of the city that we all go through, you need wisdom. Today I shudder. So one aspect of online learning that is troubling me a lot is what we have exposed, particularly the young kids, to with those pieces of gadgets. Socrates and Plato, the philosophers, said, literally, philosophy was literally the love of wisdom. You know, philo is love. Sophia is wisdom. And I hope we are getting it, that when we say wisdom is calling from the high place, is because she's there where she may be best seen and heard, where many paths meet, where there is a great concourse, and where travelers may need direction. That's why we have chapel on this journey. Not just for students, all of us on this earth. We come for chapel so as to seek direction, and that is wisdom. The places of judgment and the confluence of people, wisdom. So wisdom is calling us from that top hill. From a distance, she's calling us so that we can hear and become. So I was scribbling these notes and I said, wisdom is just around the corner. That's why all of us, the chaplain, my colleague, lecturers, our SADU leadership, DUSA leadership, the DCF, you see, they are all agents of wisdom. They're just around the corner, management of the university. But we can see her on the hill and hear her as we walk down the road. So people keep on telling you matters of wisdom. It is present around us. And I'm saying she waits by the door of our house when we go out and when we come back home. And I'm being deliberately philosophical. She's at the Westgate Mall or Naivas Mall. She's at that movie theater. Wisdom. She is at our workplace. She is at the grocery or the kiosk. Wisdom is at the hospital. And I'm sorry to say, wisdom is also at the bar. Those drinking places. Wherever we go, she is there. The question is, are we listening? That is the question. The big question is, are we listening to the voice of wisdom? And God's desire, equate that to wisdom, is to speak to everyone. But me, I think she, wisdom here, wants to speak to two types of people. And I'm just a vessel. Wisdom wants to speak to the simple people. Why? Because usually they are very naive. Wisdom also wants to speak, as the Bible says, to the fools. Those who ignore understanding. Unajua hii kitu inaitwa wisdom. Tunaweza fikiria ya kwamba our VC anaongea mambo ya kawaida. Siongei mambo ya kawaida leo. Jana niliona kijana kama nyinyi ambaye anataka kuwa governor wa Nairobi. Anataka kuwa governor. I was at a function recently of launching a book. I don't know whether Leah is here. She's not here. I was at that function, and Linus Kaikai was the MC. And he kept on standing and telling us, I would like to recognize so-and-so. So I would like to recognize Kipruto Kirwa, who was our agriculture minister. I want to recognize Kilimo. Who was this? I want to recognize just Peter Kenneth. I want to recognize Pasalis. I want to, you know, those were the important people. But me, I know in that audience, we had medical doctors, we had lawyers, we had professors. You see, we lack wisdom to the level we think you are only significant when you become an MCA. He was even mentioning MCAs there. And yet I saw many judges, Effie Award, the first woman judge. They were there, but they're just quiet. Our head of NIS, the one who started the national intelligence, he was there. Nobody was mentioning him. So when I stood up, I was asked, I had the privilege to talk. I said, this is a strange country. Because recognition rotates around politicians. So may I take this opportunity? Are there any lawyers here? So they stood up. Are there any medical doctors who take care of our health? They stood up. Are there any, you know, businessmen? Are there any church people here? and very prominent people, but nobody had thought about them. I'm talking about wisdom is around the corner, but only if you are able to listen the voice that they're giving us. So I am saying this. If we read Proverbs 8:5, please post Proverbs 8:5. You who are simple gain prudence, and you who are foolish set your hearts on it. And ladies and gentlemen, all of us have probably been foolish at some point or another in our lives. And all of us, therefore, could use some wisdom as we move forward. So, my students, and you mean so much to some of us because you are the future. This morning I was having a very interesting conversation with our chair of DCF, the new chair, and I was probing his past. I want to emphasize to you that this thing called wisdom comes out of knowledge, I hope you remember, experience, and good judgment. You know, there are people, there are students, maybe not in Daystar, but there are students who will join Daystar, and they will go through their courses, and you'll be surprised, they will never have read any book other than what is being given by the various courses. So how do you get the experience? Many of us spend our time on the phone. And by the way, this is a national crisis. If you cumulatively add the hours we spend on the phone as a country, that has reduced our economic development. Yes, because we are permanently on the phone. Can we have the wisdom to start controlling our appetite for the phone? Think about it. You wake up from bed and the first thing you want to touch is your phone. That is, today, that is the opium of the mind. Hiyo ndio kasumba ya akili. So many of us have outsourced our brains totally to Google. I'm asking that we may use wisdom to change our direction. And I want to say this very clearly. I'm sure that the students from the US, you must be shocked at the usage of mobile phone in Kenya. I'm sure you're shocked. Because I can't believe it. And you know, that usage is an expenditure. It is not for free. It's not for free. And you might think it. The other day, I went to my M-Pesa account. I made a mistake. I went to some account, M-Pesa, then I was navigating. Then they were giving me the money I have transacted. I almost collapsed. I could not believe it. It's a ridiculous figure, 20-something, almost 30 million Kenya shillings on my phone. Why don't you try and work out how much you are using on airtime? Just do it as research. How much are you using on airtime? Somebody said, somebody told me, no, me, I don't use much. I use 200 bob per day. 200 bob per day? What does wisdom tell me? Times 30. That is how much? Yeah, 200 times 30 is 6,000, isn't it? Yeah, 30 days times 200 is 6,000. times 12 months. Hiyo ni airtime. Sijaingia huko kwa bundles huko kwingine huko. I would like to say this. God makes a promise in verse 6. He says that when he speaks, he will tell us excellent things. They will be right. They will be true. There will be no half-truths found on his lips. There will be no deception in his voice. Nothing crooked or perverse will we find in what God says. God is righteous, and what he speaks is righteous too. So the value of his instruction is more important than silver. It is more important than gold. And the value of his instruction is obviously prized beyond rubies. So instructions must not only be heard, it must be received for wisdom. Can we prefer wisdom before riches? And I want to say we at Daystar, and hopefully in the Republic of Kenya, must receive God's instruction as most important. Because Jesus says in Matthew 6:33, but seek first his kingdom and his righteousness, and all these things will be given to you as well. So I was talking about this young man. I don't know whether he's 33 or he's... And we have a right to talk about him because he has stepped in the public arena. And we know as Nairobians, we elected somebody as a governor and we know what happened. But what I'm asking is, where is wisdom? If you know you only did high school, and you know that to become a governor in Kenya, you must have a degree, where is the wisdom? And I was talking to his teacher. He was at Lenana High School. I was talking to the teacher, and he was saying, you know, he was the chairman of the Christian Union, and he was the most respected person in that school. And then she was telling me, you know, my daughter, the daughter is a graduate, she has finished. That person gave her an award for singing well in the baby class choir. And this person was in Form 4 that year. And the girl we are talking about is now about 31 years. So how old is he? What are we saying? If you turn to Proverbs 8, 12 to 21, and I want us to listen to this, it says, I, wisdom, dwell together with prudence. I possess knowledge and discretion. To fear the Lord is to hate evil. I hate pride and arrogance, evil behavior, and perverse speech. Counsel and sound judgment are mine. I have insight, I have power. By me, kings reign, and rulers issue decrees that are just. By me, princes govern, and nobles, all who rule on earth. So I love those who love me, and those who seek me find me. With me are riches and honor, enduring wealth and prosperity. My fruit is better than fine gold. What I yield surpasses choice silver. I walk in the way of righteousness along the paths of justice, bestowing a rich inheritance on those who love me and making their treasures full. That is wisdom. So I am challenging all of us that wisdom gives men good heads. Wanabeba vichwa vizuri. Wengine tunabeba mawe. Tunabeba mawe nzito kwa kichwa. They dwell with prudence and knowledge and discretion. I think from what I've read there, that passage, Proverbs 8, 12 to 21, wisdom gives men good hearts. Good hearts. They dwell in the fear of the Lord. They hate all sin, pride, arrogance, and the way of evil. They stay away from lies and a perverse mouth. My senior management are here. And you know, 2 years ago, we were just not wise. I don't want to reveal your discussions in senior management. We're just not wise. We are not wise. The things we are doing, because we are being told wisdom gives men good hearts. So when you see you are having a heart that hates somebody else, just know wisdom has disappeared. Wisdom gives men well-governed societies. They are wonderful counselors and rule with fairness or justice. And I'm talking to all of us. Even my DUSA team, Daystar Christian Fellowship team, DULOS, DC3, all of you. If you are a person of wisdom, you will govern, you will rule with justice, and you become a counselor for your team. Wisdom gives men true happiness. Yeah, true happiness. And I'm quoting Wesley here, they are satisfied with the riches of God. The things of this world may fill men's bellies, but not their spiritual bank accounts. So how many US dollars does your spiritual bank account hold? Wisdom promises believers goods laid up, not for days, not for years, but for eternity. And her fruit is better than gold. And this is what Jesus said in Matthew 6, 19 to 21. Do not store up for yourselves treasures on earth, where moths and vermin destroy, and where thieves break in and steal. But store up for yourselves treasures in heaven, where moths and vermin do not destroy, and where thieves do not break in and steal. For where your treasure is, there your heart will be also. There's this story, as I wind up, of a PS in this country. PS means principal secretary, very, very high up there. They had gone around corruption to collect money from two institutions, and I think the government was building projects there, so they went and got money, and they put the money in the boot. The driver, the poor driver, saw bags of money, wakaweka kwa boot. So as this man was driving the PS to their rural home, It was announced the president had done a reshuffle. They had changed. So this guy is on the radio and the driver akasikia habari kitangazo ya kwamba fulani amehamishwa, ameenda kwa wizara fulani, fulani ameenda huku, lakini huyu hakuwa na wizara. So wakati driver alifika na mkubwa akatoka kwa gari, huyu driver akajua hii ni siku yangu ya mwisho na huyu mtu. So he took off with the 5 million in the boot. And he just disappeared. He took off. Where would the PS go and report? There's nowhere. Where would she have gone to say, this man has run away with my 5 million? Because the bank can only give you a maximum of 1 million, but with also evidence. So now on easy treasures, this easy vitu tunajiwekea, zinaweza kupotea siku moja. Lakini mwenendo na matumaini ya kwenda huko binguni itaishi milele na milele. I want us to know that right from Genesis, it seems God was packaged. God packaged wisdom within himself. Read Genesis on the creation. And so for me, wisdom is primary and fundamental. You must have wisdom. And when I was reading extracts from the beginning, Genesis, wisdom reveals herself as preceding all creation, stamped upon it all, one with God, yet in some way distinguishable from him as the object of his love. It is the foundation on which all life is built. And in Psalms 104:24, the psalmist tells us, how many are your works, Lord? In wisdom you made them all. The earth is full of your creatures. And so by wisdom, the Lord laid the earth's foundations. By understanding, he set the heavens in place. And by his knowledge, the watery depths were divided, and the clouds let drop the dew. So, can you continue to listen to wisdom's words? And some of you whom we have had very deep conversation, and many, many in this hall, on many issues, we just sit down and talk deep conversation. You know, I try so much to be wise. And I would plead with all of us in this hall to listen to wisdom's words all the time. Listen to wisdom's words all the time. So, Chaplain, I know I have disappointed you sometimes because you are my friend and then you are my boss. He's my boss, by the way, spiritually. But you know, me, I know that you are wise. Ata ile maneno tulikuwa tunaongea when you came kneeling, crying for one member of staff. And I told you, you know, suspend that. That is wisdom. And you listened. I'm not talking about the chaplain. I'm talking about all of us. My sister, Josephine Munyao. You know, wisdom should tell you that, should tell you how the VC thinks and operates. So when I say that person is too critical, through Daystar. I am not just saying words. No, I'm not just saying words. I'm not engaged in pretending. I am not engaged just in words. I am saying something very deep. That is what is wisdom. It is knowledge. It is experience. And it is judgment. And I just want you to reflect on this. It's not an easy thing, but we continue. And many of the things that we say, if they are not anchored in Scripture, if you don't understand what the nature of wisdom, many things can pass you by. So I'm hoping that my chief finance manager can get me some money, because I want to take the DUSA DCF, the student leadership. You know, quite a number of these boys and girls have never been to Mombasa. They can pretend, but they have never been there. You know, they will think if they say they have not been to Mombasa, it will be foolish. Some of them have never been to Mombasa. So I want to take them to Mombasa, but one of the conditions, everybody, starting with the vice chancellor, must have a swimming trunk. So we will also go to see how many of us can swim, you know. But is that why we are going to Mombasa? No, there is inner wisdom. I want my students to know me and to know the management, and that they will know if there is a problem, we can approach a hero and he will listen. Lakini pale pengine tulienda, panaitwa Naivasha, inaitwa nini yo? That place. Yeah, there is some place we went to. I don't think it was wise. It is efficient. You know, Naivasha is very near. So at a diesel, your bus ni kidogo sana. But there is inner wisdom. When you hear me, Phil is saying, I must take the team to Mombasa. I want to go with them. I want to sit them at table and know how many can use knives and forks. Yeah. I'm giving some of these examples jokingly, but there is inner wisdom that goes into, like, for example, having a retreat with the students. It's expensive, but me, I think it will allow us to be together. And together, we will solve the problems of Daystar without conflict. Now then, if you can turn to Proverbs 8:32-36. Now then, my children, listen to me. Blessed are those who keep my ways. Listen to my instruction and be wise. So do not disregard it. Blessed are those who listen to me, watching daily at my doors, waiting at my doorway. For those who find me find life and receive favor from the Lord. But those who fail to find me harm themselves, all who hate me but love death. Proverbs 8:32. So what is my message today? Surely we should listen to God's voice. We should listen as if our lives were dependent upon the words that are spoken, because they are. Only God gives life, physical as well as eternal life. Should we not listen to him? Let us all be wise and not refuse such instruction. And in my thinking, blessed are those who hear the God's voice and wait on him with daily reading, meditation, and prayer. During our prayer day, we exhaustively looked at what it means to pray and why we pray. We pray because it's an instruction from God, but we also pray because prayer works. So let us all be wise and not refuse such instruction. So blessed are those who hear God's voice, I'm repeating this, and wait on him with daily reading, meditation, and prayer. The young men here, young women, you find time for very useless entertainment. Some of you can finish a year without adding a single vocabulary to your language register. Not a single, because you don't read. You don't read. Can we not find time to listen to our Father? And my parting shot is for all of us to assess the number of hours we spend on the phones. It is a tragedy. I have met many respectable people who will not talk to you on phone. The best they will do is send an SMS and you communicate the same. Pius, I called you, was it last night? No, the other night. Yeah. How many minutes did we talk? How many? 1 minute? No, half a minute. Lakini tukianza nikikupigia simu uanze kuniambia bwana visi habari gani? Mzuri. Uko athiriva ama uko Nairobi? Niko athiriva. Na leo kumenyesha uko athiriva kweli? And you know, he's just 40 kilometers from here and he's asking me whether it has rained in athiriva. Na leo nimesikiza habari kwa runinga. Naona kuna maneno uko kwenu. Maneno gani? Kuna mtu nasikia ameua watoto wake watano. Sasa, dunia imeharibika sana. And yet I was asking him for one small thing. But now we are engaging in what I call useless virtue. Yeah, we are talking about things that don't make sense. So we continue. Talking. Do you know, sometimes I get into North Rift. Kuna magari na safiri kwenda nyumbani huko Eldoret. Kama staki kwenda na gari, naingia kwa North Rift, nakaa katikati. Mimi naogopa sana kukaa mbele na driver. Najua wengi wenu mnapenda kukaa na driver hapo mbele. Mimi siwezi kaa hapo mbele. Sijui nitakuwa nimefunga mabrakes mangapi hapo mbele. And from Nairobi or from Eldoret, somebody is on the phone. Tutaenda hivyo, tupite Eldoret, Burnt Forest, tuende wapi, tufike Nakuru. The break. Tukirudi tena kwa hiyo gari, they are on the phone. Until you land in Nairobi. But you know, if you had a book, you'll have read at least 3, 4, 5 chapters. So, let us not engage in useless virtue. And by the way, these people who are on the phone throughout have no regard for who you are. Wataendelea kuongea, hiyo harufu yao mbaya ya mdomo inakusumbua. Alafu jua likianza kuwaka, socks zinanuka, na anazidi kuongea. I am talking about being wise. So please let us not show contempt for God's instructions by turning a deaf ear to him. Christ, Christ is our wisdom. He is life to all believers. We cannot obtain God's favor unless we find Christ and listen to him. Because Jesus said in John 10, 27 to 28, my sheep listen to my voice. I know them and they follow me as I give them eternal life. And they shall never perish, nor one will snatch them out of my hand. So as I finish, my question for you today is, do you hear his voice? This hidden voice on the hill, do you hear his voice? Are you following him? Please let us learn to embrace the virtue of wisdom. And I can go deeper, but not for today. I just want you to ask yourself, have I been wise in what I've been doing? And am I following God's word? If we did that, not just Daystar, but Kenya and beyond, will be a better place because we shall have produced wise men and women. You cannot be wise without knowledge. My students, just ask yourself, am I assembling enough knowledge? Am I going through meaningful experiences in life? Those are some of the things that will then enhance our wisdom through Jesus Christ, our Savior. Let us stand. We want to conclude by another old song. And you people, bear with me, the young people, just bear with me. You know, you have a vice chancellor who is a cake. So he keeps on bringing these old songs. Just bear with me. And keep praying that one day you'll have a younger vice chancellor who will rap with you. You can rap and do that. So what a friend we have in Jesus. Let's go. ni wangapi wanajua huu wimbo kwa Kiswahili. Yesu kwetu ni rafiki, huambiwa haja pia. Tukiomba kwa Baba, maombi yasikia. Lakini twajikosesha, twajitweka vibaya, kwamba tulimwomba Mungu dua angesikia. Una dhiki na maonjo, una mashaka pia. Haifai kuwa moyo, dua atasikia. Hakuna mwengine mwema wa kutuhurumia, atujua kwa dhaifu, maombi yasikia. Je, hunayo hata nguvu, huwezi kuendelea? Ujapo dharauliwa, ujapo rushwa pia. Watu wangekudharau, wapendao dunia, hukwambata mikononi, dua atusikia. Thank you. Let us clap for the Lord. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Once again, let us appreciate our Vice Chancellor for leading us through. Wonderful. Thank you so much. I'd like to thank each and every one of you for coming to the chapel today. I'd like to thank our ushers, the camera crew, Santeni Sana, the keyboardist, the drummers, praise and worship, sound crew, our floor manager, Paul Kebabs. Thank you. James Asante Sana and the Tabs, once again, thank you so much for leading us. Let me call Joy Tele, please come to the stage. And also let me call Professor Boyo to come to close for us with a word of prayer. As Prof comes, today we are baptizing four people. This one is representing them. She's one of the people we are baptizing today, Joy. And there is another lady called Patience who's not here with us. And we have two students from Howard University we are also baptizing today. And that is Chausiku and Amina. Those two, we are baptizing them today. What do you remember about the sermon today? Nature and value of wisdom. Eh? Three things about wisdom. Knowledge, experience, judgment. Something about phones, you remember? Thank you, our Vice Chancellor. I'd like to request Professor Boyo to bless us as we conclude our service.
In the words of 2 Peter chapter 3, verse 14 and 15, Peter, writing about Paul, he says, bear in mind that our Lord's patience means salvation. Just as our dear brother Paul also writes with you in the wisdom that God gave him. He writes the same way in all his letters, speaking in them all these matters. His letters contain some things that are hard to understand, which ignorant and unstable people distort as they do other scriptures to their own destruction. Our VC has spoken to us. And believe you me, he has spoken deep things. He has used fables. He has used parables. He has used illustrations. But my friends, it was not just those things that he was talking about. It was very deep. And may the Lord help us that we may be able to understand what God is saying in and through his servant. Let us pray. Our most gracious Heavenly Father, indeed we are humbled before your presence this morning. Heavenly Father, we know that you brought us here for a purpose. And the purpose is to hear your voice, which has come to us, all of us who sat down and listened through your servant, the vessel that you chose to use today, our Vice Chancellor. How we pray, Lord, that the things he has spoken will find a place in our hearts. That, Lord, we shall exercise wisdom in every aspect of our life. That we shall be prudent in all that we do. And that, Father, above all, we shall honor and glorify you. You are our God, our Savior, our Redeemer, our King, our Provider. You will neither leave us nor forsake us. And we believe that, Lord, you are going to do even much more greater things than we can think or even fathom. We ask for your blessings upon each one of us, for all our students, and even those who have come to be with us, albeit for a short time from the U.S., that, Lord, this message will have a place in each of our lives. And now as we depart from your presence, to go and serve you in the various capacities, in various responsibilities, in duties that you have called us to, as teachers, as students, as workers in this vineyard, may we do it with all wisdom. May that knowledge and the experience and good judgment that brings about the right decisions be indeed our guide today. May your Holy Spirit walk with us. Taomba baraka zako zienende pamoja nasi, kila mmoja wetu. Kwa yale yote ambayo tutayatenda leo, kwa yale yote ambayo yako mbele yetu, hata siku za usoni, Mungu wetu, wewe uwe tumaini, kimbilio na tegemeo letu. Zidi kuwa nasi na uzidi kutubariki, na uzidi kutujaza na hekima itokayo kwako. Ili yale yote tuyatendayo, yale yote tunayo yawaza, yale tunayo yanena, yaweze kuwa yamekubalika mbele zako. Asante Mungu wetu, pokea sifa na shukrani zetu. And now may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Amen.
Thank you. We are free. On Thursday, we are meeting here again for a special chapel. Karibuni sana and God bless you. Thank you so much.